Hello children, and welcome back to your English class. Children, in the previous class, I explained you chapter 1, the nightingale. So now we'll be doing the new words along with its meaning. Alright? So, children, what you are supposed to do is, take your English classwork notebook, leave one page, take the second page, right hand side, on the second page, the right hand side, you have to first put today's date, that is 8th May 2020. Then you come to the writing part. Now, here above the margin, you will write CW classwork. Alright, this you have to write above the margin. Then below the margin, on the first line, you will write the name of the chapter. It is chapter 1, the nightingale. Here children, just ensure that when you're writing the heading of the chapter, the nightingale, the T of THE, the, should be capital, and N of nightingale, the first letter, should be capital. Okay? After that, you will leave one line. In the next line, you will write, towards the left hand side, you will write new word, and towards the right hand side, you will write meaning. Okay? In between, you'll use a ruler, a scale, to draw a line. You're going to write it very neatly, okay? Your writing should be quite legible and it should really be, you know, very neat and tidy. Now, after leaving one line, then you come and write the first number. Number one, porcelain, okay? And the meaning of porcelain, a substance used to make cups, plates, decorative items, etc. Leave one line, the second word you will write after leaving one line, that is stretched, and then you write the meaning of it, extended. Okay, extended. Then again you leave a line, write the third one, stream, a small narrow river. Leave one line again, write the fourth one, reflected, shown an image of something or someone on a surface such as mirror or water. Okay, leave another line, then you come to the next line. Number five, delicate, fragile, easy to damage. Leave one line. Number six, agreed, said yes to something. Leave one line. Seventh, notes, a small bit of sound. Leave one line. Number eight, trickling, moving slowly like a thin stream. Leave another line. Come to the next line. Number nine, remarkable, which means exceptional or excellent. Leave one line. Come to the next line. Number 10, assembled, gathered in one place. Leave one line. Come to the next line. Write number 11, wept. And the meaning of wept is cried. Leave another line. Come to the next line. Number 12, hated, meaning disliked. Leave one line. Next line, number 13, imprisoned, meaning kept in prison. Leave one line. Come to the next line. Write number 14, furious, very angry. Leave one line, come to the next line. Number 15, wisest, most sensible. Leave one line, come to the next line. 16th, worn, damaged. Leave one line, come to the next line. Number 17, valuable, which means precious. So these are the word meanings which you are going to write it beautifully in your classwork notebook. So children, please do complete this work. After this, you will leave one line and then you will write, make sentences with the given words. Okay, after leaving a line, you have to write this. Then again you leave a line and write the first word, delicate. Children, I have written two sentences for each word. You can refer to this, but you have to frame your own sentence. Okay, you have to make your own sentence, and that is what you have to write in your classwork notebook. Okay, so like the first word, delicate, And the sentence that we have framed is, babies have very delicate skin. Okay, start the sentence with a capital letter, end it with a full stop, underline the word delicate. Okay, so babies have very delicate skin, or rose petals are very delicate. You can, in fact, you should frame your own sentence. Okay, let's see the second one. The second word is agree. I always agree with my parents. I never agree with my friends if they are wrong. Whatever sentence you frame, remember, starting with capital letter and ending with a full stop, underlining the word agree. All these things that you have to remember, ensure that you're doing it. Okay? Now let's see the third word. The third word is wept. Rita wept bitterly on losing her favorite toy. Priya wept at the sad news given to her by her friend. Start with capital, end with full stop, underline the word wept. The fourth word is hate. I hate milk, but I love coffee. We should not hate anyone. Start with capital, end with full stop, underline the word hate. Furious. Next word is furious. I had never seen my father so furious. My dad became furious when I broke his watch. Now again, starting with capital, ending with full stop, underline the word furious. And children, remember that you have to leave a line after completion of every sentence. Okay, so leaving a line is mandatory. You have to leave a line after every sentence. Okay, so try to frame your own sentence with these five words. Okay, and write it neatly. This has to be done in your classwork notebook. Stay blessed. Bye-bye.